In this video, what I wanted to do was to actually share with you an interesting observation that I have been making in some research I have done about a country that we've all heard of, Dubai. In fact, to be technically correct, Dubai is not even a country. It's actually a combination of seven emirates. But regardless, the fact is that Dubai has gone from being just a desert to becoming one of the most prosperous international cities in a space of under 60 years. The interesting thing is that a lot of people don't realize that Dubai as a country, is not like some of the other Middle Eastern countries where they had a lot of oil or they had a lot of resources. So the question then becomes, how is it that a country that was not as well resourced as some of the other countries in the world, what did that country do in such a short space of time to become extremely resourceful? And the reason I decided to do this topic is because a lot of people in the world have this underlying belief that in order for them to have resources, they need to start with some resources, and that's actually not true. There has been so many examples of individuals who've gone from rags to riches, meaning that they've used their resourcefulness to create resources. And of course, there are examples of countries like Dubai who have also done the same thing. They have used their resourcefulness to create resources, whereas a lot of people wait and play victims, thinking that, well, the reason I'm struggling financially, or the reason I'm not prosperous, or the reason I cannot create wealth is because I don't have the resources to start with. But the thing is, resources are not going to help a person who is not resourceful. Resources are not going to help a group or a nation that is not resourceful to start with. And the point that I really wanted to make through this example was that resourcefulness results in the accumulation of resources, not the other way around. And Dubai is a perfectly fantastic example of a country that was not blessed with natural resources like a lot of other countries. And yet, despite that, because of the resourcefulness demonstrated by their leaders, it has, in a space of 60 years, gone from being a desert to becoming one of the most successful international cities in the world. One of the key figures in the development of Dubai was Sheikh Mohammed, who was responsible for a lot of the leadership that has become quite evident in the development of Dubai. So I think many years ago, what had actually happened was that the Sheikh sat down with his team and he said, well, let's look at what we can do. We don't have some of the resources that other countries have, but what do we have? And they used their brain power and they used their creativity to come up with ideas and strategies that would make Dubai a very, very successful country from a financial point of view. One of the first things that they did was they identified that Dubai sat in the middle of the East and West. And so the first thing that they thought was, well, if we can make Dubai a transit point, and if we could get travelers who are traveling from the East to the West or from the West to the East to stop in Dubai and spend some time there, then that could create a lot of opportunities for Dubai. And so they were very good at raising funds through investors because of their strategic plan of action. And as they did that, they were able to attract a lot of entrepreneurs and investors who then invested money in the infrastructure that we see in Dubai today, starting with one of the main infrastructure points that they have, which is the airport, in which they then constructed shopping malls and things like that, because what they wanted to do was for people to come and actually spend time there. And that was one of the things that I find very fascinating, is that how they thought through this and how they felt that by attracting funding and getting investors to invest in the country, they could create the type of infrastructure which would compel a lot of the travelers to spend time in Dubai and also increase spending within Dubai, which would then result in economic cash flow coming into the country. One of the other things that they did was they incentivized investors and entrepreneurs. They realized that they have to incentivize wealth generators, and so they created very significant tax concessions for people who wanted to invest either in real estate or wanted to start up companies. And again, this was just the resourcefulness that they adopted by saying, look, we don't have money, we want to attract money, but there are people out there in different parts of the world who have the money. How can we make it very attractive for them to come and want to build businesses in this country, which would generate wealth, create employment, but also how do we get them to invest, which would then result in generational wealth within the economy as well. And of course, that generational wealth could be used for further infrastructure spending. Again, a remarkable example of thinking through things and not making it difficult for really ambitious people, who are industrialists and business people and investors, not making it difficult for these types of people to be able to invest and build businesses, which unfortunately a lot of people make it very difficult within their companies, even like a lot of governments make it very difficult for investors and entrepreneurs. And even sometimes those countries and those organizations are sitting on a lot of resources, but because of poor mismanagement and because of not really appreciating the value of talent, and not appreciating that, you know, a lot of high performers are deterred if there are not enough incentives for them. A lot of companies and a lot of countries don't demonstrate this type of thinking, unfortunately, because of which they end up losing the talent and they end up losing opportunities. But this is something that Dubai did extremely well. The third thing that Dubai did extremely well is they really worked on the efficiency of labor. They wanted to maximize labor in such a way that would produce high output. So the focus wasn't just on input, it wasn't just on the amount of work that people were going to do, it was really on production. So the focus went from just labor into production, which also resulted in Dubai actually creating things, creating infrastructure, and creating organizations, creating companies, because it was all about production. The emphasis was on production, not just mere labor. A lot of the times what happens is when a country has very strong labor laws, this is just my personal opinion, what ends up happening is the labor is supported, but in many ways it also stifles productivity and performance, because there is not much incentive for people to produce. People are rewarded for the inputs, but there are not massive incentives available for them to produce output. So when a country gets this piece right, there is a natural increase in production performance in many, many cases. And that's another point that a lot of individuals and companies don't understand, that even if you have developed the best product or best service in the world, unless you learn how to package it and promote it effectively, if you don't know how to market it, you're still not going to be able to attract people. And this is something that Dubai did very well. The leadership team, they looked at positioning Dubai as a brand, and that's what resulted in that fascination factor. And so that's why Dubai is able to attract massive tourism from different countries, where people want to come, and then they share more about Dubai in their pictures and their videos, which then attracts more international travelers. Of course, I can go on and on about a lot of the very specific things that Dubai did, but I didn't want to do that in this video, because that's something that you can research through Google yourself. The point was very simple. When somebody is not resourceful, resources don't help. And yet at the same time, when you don't have resources, but you can exhibit resourcefulness, you can accumulate resources. This is a point that so many people don't understand. And as somebody who specializes in wealth, I find this absolutely fascinating, because somebody like me, who also came from no resources, realized that as long as we're alive, as long as we have a mind that's working, as long as we have a heart that's functioning, as long as we've got our arms and eyes and we have creativity, we can think, we can produce something from nothing. And this is exactly what Dubai has done. Of course, a lot of other countries have also done a lot of these things. And you, at the same time, you'll see examples of countries that have been blessed with resources but mismanaged those resources. As a consequence, they went from prosperity to lack of productivity, lack of innovation, lack of performance. And the interesting thing also is you will find that a lot of the times hardship drives performance. If you actually look at history of the world, you'll find that a lot of the times hard times end up producing highly resourceful people. Highly resourceful people then end up producing good times. But unfortunately, if good times prevail for too long, that ends up producing weak people who don't perform. And then, of course, those weak people end up producing hard times again. And the cycle continues. But this is important for us to understand, because when we start to just look at the economic climate, or we look at the circumstances and we think, well, I don't really have any influence over this, we need to start to understand that if a country that had no strategic advantage from a resources point of view really thought through and thought, hey, what do we have and how can we maximize it? Imagine if every individual and every company thought like that, rather than complaining, rather than pointing fingers at the economy or the government. If every single individual, if every single team, if every single organization started to think about, hey, what do I really have and how can I maximize those resources? And really, before asking for more resources, if they ask themselves, am I maximizing what I already have before I ask for more? If we all had that mindset and attitude, what would happen? I think what would happen is there'd be tremendous amount of prosperity in the world, and we would reduce the dependence, we would reduce the acquired helplessness that we produced in the world today. And if every man and woman looked after themselves and became strategically smart, became resourceful, and became independent, what could the world produce? Think about it. It could minimize homelessness. It could minimize beggary. It could create so much self-sufficiency. But unfortunately, until mindsets change, economies cannot change. And that's really my point that I wanted to make in this particular video for you. Okay, here is what I want you to do. I want you to identify a resource that you've always had, but you have not identified and you're not maximizing. Think about this. If you're young, you have time. If you're old, you have experience. If you've gone through a lot of challenges, you have probably mental toughness because you've overcome adversity. Each one of us has a resource that in many cases is hidden to us. And when we understand what those resources are, we can maximize our resourcefulness in turn, which produces more resources for us.